This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. Before we start building some of our endpoints, I wanted to configure and create a way of automatically generating documentation for the API endpoints that we build. So API documentation is important, and there are many different reasons why that is. Whether it be because you want to showcase the features that the API provides so that developers know how to interact with your API, whether you want to generate good documentation to help new developers get started quickly, providing clear explanation of how to utilize the API, or you want to potentially have clear documentation to potentially reduce errors and misunderstandings when integrating the front end and the back end. It can obviously save time. Time is money. So good documentation can save time and money by reducing the amount of back and forth that there might be between developers and API providers. So clear documentation allows developers to get the information they need without having to reach out to kind of customer support. It's just there in the documentation. It promotes adoption. You know, when an API is well documented, it's more likely to be adopted by developers. Of course, this type of application that we're building here isn't necessarily going to be built for other developers as such, but if it is an open source API, then having good documentation is always beneficial. So what we're going to be doing in this tutorial is installing DRFSpectacular, which is a tool which is essentially going to scan our code and generate a schema, a set of code, which can then be utilized by a user interface such as Swagger to present information related to our API. If you head over to the documentation, the installation process is very simple. Just need to pip install DRFSpectacular. Zoom in a little bit there. So go back to the terminal. If you need to, press Control and C to just stop the server if you've got that running, and then pip install DRFSpectacular. I think I've already got it installed. So the second step, we're told here that we need to just add this to the installed apps. So let's go ahead and do that. That's going to be in our DJ Chat settings here. So up the top in our stored apps. Now here you might want to start to create some documentation just to provide a division between external and internal apps. External, maybe, and then you just add internal so that you can clearly identify any third-party apps that you're using and the internal apps that you've generated. So then finally, we need to register our Spectacular Auto Schema with DRF. So let's go ahead and add this into the REST framework settings in our settings. So default schema class. So we're just defining the fact that we're going to be utilizing DRFSpectacular for our default schema class. So back in our settings here, should be down the bottom. I think we already started building this. No, we didn't. I thought we already had added something. We hadn't. So that's not a problem. We can just copy the whole thing and then let's move it into the bottom here. So let's just get rid of that. So we'll add more to this a bit later. So this is settings related to Django DRF. The last step here is the Spectacular settings. Now, what we will see shortly when we start to use Swagger UI is an interface which has multiple metadata associated to it. And this is just some of the metadata that we can add to make it customized for our particular project. So here we can define the title, the description, the version, and serve include schema false. So these are just some of the settings that we can include. I paused here, sorry, serve include schema, because we can specify whether we want to make the schema available or not as a download, for example. So we just set that to false. In fact, we'll take a look at the benefit of that or the purpose of that shortly when we actually build a new schema. now that we have that in place, we can now go ahead and generate a schema. Now, the problem here is that we don't have any endpoints, but we're just preparing this in preparation for us to then build some endpoints, and then we can start utilizing this and seeing it in actions. But we can get this all started without any endpoints. So let's go ahead and run the command here. So we're going to generate a new schema. And like I said, generally what's happening here is that DRFSpectacular is going to look at our views, look for any endpoints, look at the code, and generate a schema. It's going to generate some metadata, which is going to be able to record or describe the endpoints that we have in our system. And then we can then utilize this schema and Swagger UI to present the data utilizing the graphical user interface. So let's go ahead and run this and see what happens. So run that, and you'll notice that a new schema file, a YAML file, has been created. Notice that there's nothing here apart from some of the information that we've described in settings. So you can see this is where the title, version, description is going to be placed and then utilized for our graphical user interface to display. So you can go ahead and change some of this spectacular settings, and there are of course many more that you can add looking through the documentation. So now we have our schema. We can now present it utilizing a user interface. We're going to be utilizing Swagger. This is all built in when we downloaded DRFSpectacular. Right, so first of all then, head over to DJ Chat URLs. From here, we're going to add in a few different resources. Apologies, I'm not going to do this letter by letter here, character by character. So first of all, we need to bring in from DRFSpectacular, the Spectacular API view, which is then going to give us access to, for example, the schema, to be able to download the schema, and then the Swagger, Spectacular Swagger view. And that's going to then provide us the interface to actually see the user interface, display the schema documentation, utilizing the Swagger UI interface. Okay, right. So let's go ahead and add some URLs. So first of all is to the schema. This is going to allow us to download the schema if we wanted that. And then the second URL here, and we don't actually need that, so I'm just remove that. The second endpoint here, or URL pattern, this is going to be to access the actual Swagger UI. So those are the two endpoints. So once you've typed those out, go ahead and just start up the server again, and we can go ahead and start to access these endpoints. Right, so if you just navigate over to the root directory, you should now be able to see the two endpoints that we've just created here. So the first one is to the schema. So we can use this to download the schema if we wanted to. So slash that, that should then start a download. You can see that downloaded a file. And then if we then go back and then go to the UI, that should then provide us or show us the user interface, the Swagger UI. And there we go. At this point, we don't have any API endpoints. That's what we're going to be working on in the next couple of tutorials, of course. But we can start to see this interface and potentially what it provides us. Now, notice that I've just added this on. So if you go back into settings and you change the serve include schema to true, then this will present you with this endpoint here for the schema. So if you just refresh. If you haven't, and here you can see that this is providing the type of interface that we're going to be seeing with the other endpoints that we generate. We have a drop down here, we have some documentation about an endpoint, we have then some parameters, so we can start to interact with the endpoint. And what we can do is we can try it out. So we've got an option here of trying it out, we can pass in some different parameters and execute, and then that will present us with a result from our endpoint. So that's what we're going to be working with for documentation, so that we can potentially, as a front-end developer, we can come to this documentation, we can take a look at the parameters that are required in order to work with the particular endpoint, as well as some additional docstring documentation here that we can generate to give the developer or the person interacting with our API more information about how to interact with the particular endpoint. That's pretty much the setup for now. We'll start to add more as we develop further in this project. But we now have everything ready, so we can start to instantly document and learn how to set up additional metadata to document our API as we start to build it.